Hi guys, today I'm going to show you how to make sauerkraut at home in small batches, super easily and super quickly. And the recipe is a genuine recipe that my mom used to make when I was a kid. I just made my sauerkraut. It looks like this. I have two jars like this in the fridge and I can't wait to tuck in. So many traditional cultures have been making some kind of fermented veggies for ages, from sauerkraut to kimchi, quats, which is fermented bread drink, kefir, yogurt. There's so many different things that cultures have been fermenting because it's so good for use for so many different reasons. So sauerkraut is full of bacteria that is so good for your digestion. It also helps produce more stomach acid, which helps you process nutrients and to digest things better, have more energy, clear your skin, and it's also great food for the bacteria that you already have in your stomach. And traditionally in Northern Europe, during the winter months when it's really cold and there are no fruits in season, people used to eat sauerkraut and it was their main vitamin C and they were extremely healthy. Raw cabbage can actually be goitrogenic, which means that it disrupts the natural function of your thyroid, but that doesn't apply to fermented cabbage, which is sauerkraut, so that's why I like it. And finally, I also love it because it saves me so much time. Every time I make some kind of meat or fish dish and I want some kind of a side of vegetables, sauerkraut is always there in the fridge. It's always easy, it doesn't have to be cooked, and it's just so convenient for those meals when you're in a hurry, you don't have much time, but you want something really healthy, full of enzymes. I love it for those days. So I guess now it's time to move on to my mom's genuine sauerkraut recipe. So you're going to need just a few simple ingredients that you probably already have in your house. So you'll just need two small cabbages or one larger cabbage, and it's around 1 kilo or just around 2.5 pounds. You'll also need 1.5 tablespoons of Himalaya salt and also 1 tablespoon of caraway seeds, and around 2 tablespoons of cranberries. Now, these two last ingredients are optional. They're just the ones that are traditionally used in Eastern Europe, in my country, which is Lithuania, also Russia. But if you want just very basic sauerkraut recipe, you can totally do without them as well. You'll also need a few tools. So you'll need 1 big 2-quart or 2-liter jar. You'll need 2 smaller jars to be used as weights. You'll also need some kitchen paper towel and also an elastic. First thing we have to do is slice the cabbage really finely, and there's a whole, you know, strategy how you can do it really quickly. So you're going to just take the cabbage and cut in half and then take out that little core, and then take one of those halves and cut in half again. And then take one of those quarters and cut it lengthwise, so you have these sort of 8 wedges. And then take each of those wedges and just slice it really thinly. And here you go, you have your cabbage thinly sliced, ready to be massaged. And then you're going to add that salt, and then you'll start massaging it, rubbing it, squeezing it with both of your hands. And it's going to take you around 10 minutes. In fact, every time I make it, it takes me exactly 10 minutes. So the beginning is going to be really dry and hard. It's going to be quite difficult to squeeze it. But as the time goes on, you'll see that it's more and more, like, softer and softer, and there's more and more liquid, and it's actually going to be quite therapeutic and quite nice for you. A side effect of this is that your nails are going to be extremely clean and really, really nice. So I love doing that for my hands. It's like a sort of enzymatic therapy for your fingers and your cuticles. I love it. So once that cabbage is really soft and full of juice, then you're going to add those cranberries and caraway seeds, mix everything together, and then take that big 2-quart jar and start stuffing everything in and squeezing to make sure that you really press everything in until, once you finish all the cabbage, at the top there should be a layer of juice. So the cabbage should always be covered by a layer of juice when it's fermenting, because otherwise it'll get mold and you don't want to get mold. So make sure there's always juice at the top, and you're going to do that by squeezing it really well. So then you're going to take those 2 small jars, fill them with water, and place them both on top of each other inside the jar and squeeze them in to, you know, to squeeze out even more juice. And then you take that kitchen paper towel, put on top, secure it with an elastic, and sauerkraut is pretty much ready for now. So then you're going to place it on the worktop and leave it there for at least 3 days to ferment at room temperature. And after those 3 days, give it a little bit of a taste, see if it tastes right for you. I personally ferment it from 4 to 5 days. It really depends on the temperature in your house, the warmer it is, the less time it needs. But just try it for yourself, see whether it's good enough for you or not. If not, just keep fermenting it. It might even take 7 days. But as soon as you feel that the acidity level is right for you, put it in the fridge and leave it there for 7 more days, because it's going to keep developing that taste and it will become much softer. And then after the 7 days, you can enjoy your homemade sauerkraut. So this recipe makes around 1 quart or 1 liter of sauerkraut. And I also like decanting it into 2 smaller half-liter jars, just because I find it takes less space in the fridge, and I just like serving it from those, you know, smaller jars. So I just do it, but it's totally up to you. But if you do use smaller jars, make sure you pack it in really nicely and, you know, squeeze it to make sure that it's always covered by juice at the top, in the same way as if you were fermenting. We love eating it with any kind of fish or meat dishes or eggs or anything really, and we don't eat a lot of it because it's, you know, it's just a garnish. It's supposed to enhance what you're eating, so just a tablespoon or 2 tablespoons with each meal, not much more than that. And it really it just enhances any meal, and it makes the digestion so light. It clears the skin, it makes you happy, gives you energy. It's a true superfood. I absolutely love it. I hope that you're going to enjoy it too. And as you can see, this recipe is so easy. There's no need to be scared of making your own sauerkraut. I also wanted to ask you a question. If you would like to see a recipe for my version of kimchi, because I know there are lots of recipes, lots of versions, and I make a really good one. If you want to see a recipe for kimchi, let me know down in the comments. And I guess that's it for sauerkraut. Thanks for watching this video. Enjoy your fermented cabbage, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.